US 212 and cuts off 50 miles.
National Forest.
it can scare the crap out of you. A rock can hit so hard, man. You can sound like a gunshot going off. Yeah, I don't like that. But I've replaced many a windshield out here. Because you're going to get rocks flying. And headlights, they'll get busted too. Thank you. quite a bit more to work out those problems. So I have a forklift, might as well take advantage of it. I'll lift this hood off, take the radiator out and all that, and set it aside. I give me access to the front of the motor, and got to take the whole front of the motor apart in order to get that backing plate off, and then replace the gaskets up there that are leaking. So far I've been pretty fortunate getting a lot of light loads and keeping the speeds down, and it really hasn't been pushing any oil out, but if I start running it hard and get heavy loads or something, it definitely pushed the oil out. So anyway, I'll be doing that more likely this winter, which isn't very far away. So I gotta make plans for that. And I mean, if it's super cold, like I was telling Melvin, which is a friend of mine that lives down the street, he said, "Oh, it's gonna be cold." I said, "Yeah, but what I do is I take one of my eight foot tarps and I'll unroll them, and I'll take one side and pull it up over the stacks and pull them down over the stacks, and them stacks are pretty high, near 12 foot something high, and then I just lift the hood would hold it up, but I won't have the hood. I guess I could just throw it over the forklift. I didn't think about that. Throw it over the forklift, and then I got a jet heater and fire that up. That jet heater and get it warm in there. I got lights. So yeah, I'll be able to stay warm, keep the metal warm enough where it doesn't hurt your hands. I remember one time I was in North Dakota and it was 50 below in the wind, and I had a pulley seize up and broke the belt, so I had to run over to Caterpillar and get a new pulley and a new belt, and man, the tools were so cold it would burn your hands, and you couldn't stand to be outside more than a couple of minutes, and I would have to run. Of course I had an APE unit that kept the inside of the truck warm. So I kept that running. I'd have to run back to the, get inside, warm my hands up. Once I was nice and warmed up, I'd run out and work for as long as I could handle it, and then run back to the truck. I had to keep doing that.